If anyone tries to manipulate you, would you know? How would you know? Not so long ago, I was caught up in this political frenzy on Twitter. And soon I realized I need to stop because it was robbing me of the things that are most precious to me, my time, my attention, and my peace of mind. But of course, this realization happened because of an incident. Few people who I followed diligently on Twitter posted fake information. This was during the farmers' protest. And when I called on to them with the information on their DM, they winked at me and said that it was all part of the game. That's when I realized that I was being manipulated. I was no longer confident on the accuracy of the tweets or the information that I've been sharing. I've deleted them and of course unfollowed. What I discovered though taught me many things. First of all, to not forward information without actually checking their authentic source. And second, to do enough research before having to even comment on it. If you don't know about it, why comment? These days I tweet on issues that I'm really confident about, and for things that are of interest to me, I do a bit of research, do some fact checking before I tweet them. So these days I'm tweeting very less because it takes a lot of time to do those fact checking. There's plenty of evidence out there that social media sites leave users vulnerable to being misled and misinformed. Some doing it unknowingly and some deliberately. But how do we know who they are? How do I know that people in my network are not manipulating my thinking? Well, that question has led me to creating three things that I should do so that I'm not manipulated online. One, don't trust everything you hear or read. Already, our brains are dealing with information overload, and if that information is not 100% accurate, then this will negatively affect our thinking and decision-taking capability. So how do you counter this? If the subject or topic is of interest to you, then you read up facts from authentic sources. For example, if it is of any government policy, then you may want to look up the facts on the government portals or their official press releases. They always have authentic information because it goes on record. Two, check your own perception or bias. These are formed when we connect with our peers and their social biases influence the way we see the information. Most stories that mislead us attempt to manipulate us emotionally. And the purpose of such manipulation is to instill fear or anger within you. The simplest way to counter this is to pause and not engage with it right away. This pause will also help you deal with your own emotions. Unless you're able to see or think clearly, it is better not to react and wait for the facts to emerge. And this needs practice. But sometimes it's quite possible that you are not able to control your emotions and will have an outburst. For times like that, number three, you trust your intuition. If it sounds too good to be true, then it probably is. No argument is flawless. No solution is perfect. Anyone who's claiming otherwise is probably manipulating you. So yes, that miracle beauty product that is being bombarded to you in all your social media handles may not really work. The simplest way to counter this kind of a manipulation is to listen to your inner voice. The more practical way though is to read the reviews. Remember, when you're unsure, it is best to take few steps back, or in this case, disconnect and regain your thoughts. It's also best to talk to someone you trust who can help you move out of this emotional whirlpool. Have you been aware of any such manipulation towards you? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Do leave it in the comment section below, or you may reach out to me in any of the social media handles that I'm in. That's it from me. Thank you so very much for watching. I'll see you next week. Until then, stay home, stay safe.